and thank you for joining me. My name is Michael Murphy. I'm a meteorologist and the climate program leader at the National Weather Service in Pendleton, Oregon. Today I'll be talking about ENSO, El Nino, and some common misconceptions of these oceanic and atmospheric processes. ENSO stands for El Nino Southern Oscillation Index. There are three general phases to ENSO. El Nino, which is the warm phase, sea surface temperature anomalies of positive 0.5 degrees Celsius or higher along the equator in the tropical Pacific Ocean. La Nina, which is the cold phase, it has sea surface temperature anomalies of minus 0.5 degrees Celsius or lower along the equator in the tropical Pacific Ocean. The neutral phase, sometimes referred to as La Nada, and this has sea surface temperature anomalies within half a degree of average along the equator in the tropical Pacific Ocean. The Southern Oscillation Index refers to the pressure differences in the Southern Hemisphere, mainly defined as differences in pressure between Darwin, Australia, and the island of Tahiti. The first phase of ENSO I'll talk about is El Nino. On the left is a diagram showing December to February average temperatures during previous El Nino years beginning in 1958. When all these El Nino years are averaged together, note the prevalence of above normal temperatures in the Pacific Northwest. In Washington and Oregon, temperatures averaged approximately 0.3 to 0.9 degrees Celsius above normal during these El Nino years. In these years, also note the area of below normal temperatures developing in the southwest and continuing eastward across much of the southern United States. The diagram on the right side of the slide shows jet stream level wind anomalies during these same El Nino years. Note the area of enhanced jet stream level associated with the subtropical jet, which extends from near Hawaii across northern Mexico and the southern U.S. There is also a strong upper-level low-pressure system noted in the Gulf of Alaska, putting the Pacific Northwest in a general southwesterly, yet split flow. This diagram shows the typical wintertime pattern during El Nino years. As noted on the previous slide, there is normally a persistent, enhanced subtropical Pacific jet across the southern portion of the U.S. and an upper-level low-pressure system south of Alaska. The polar jet stream is deflected further northeast across Canada and northern New England. The next phase of ENSO I'll talk about is La Nina. On the left is a diagram showing December to February average temperatures during previous La Nina years beginning in 1956. When all these La Nina years are averaged together, note the prevalence of below average temperatures in the Pacific Northwest. In Washington and Oregon, temperatures averaged approximately 0.5 to 1 degree Celsius below normal during these La Nina years. In these years, also note the area of above normal temperatures developing in Texas and continuing eastward across much of the southern U.S. The diagram on the right side of the slide shows jet stream level wind anomalies during these same La Nina years. Note that the subtropical jet, which extends from near Hawaii across northern Mexico and the southern U.S., is weaker, with easterly wind anomalies here. During La Nina years, there's a ridge of high pressure in the Gulf of Alaska, which helps to enhance a northwesterly flow around it into western Canada and the northwest U.S. This diagram shows the typical wintertime pattern during La Nina years. As noted on the previous slide, the subtropical jet is much weaker, if not absent, across the southern U.S. There is also a ridge of high pressure south of Alaska, with the Pacific jet stream pointed further north towards the Pacific Northwest, and the polar jet stream directed southward into the northern parts of the U.S. The diagram above on the left shows December to February temperature anomalies during previous ENSO neutral years beginning in 1953. Note the finger of cold extending down from Canada into the northern and central U.S. The Pacific Northwest typically sees near-average temperatures during ENSO neutral years. On the right side, the diagram indicates jet stream level wind anomalies during the same ENSO neutral years. Of note is the weaker Pacific jet and an area of high pressure centered over western Alaska and eastern Asia. A few common misconceptions of El Nino are: El Nino is not an individual storm system or a series of storm systems, but instead is a more general atmospheric pattern which develops from changes in tropical ocean temperatures in the Pacific Ocean. El Nino is not defined by ocean temperatures in the northern Pacific Ocean. Instead, only the tropical Pacific Ocean sea surface temperatures are used. El Nino years do not always produce abnormally wet conditions for all of California. For example, it was drier in Northern California during 1965 and 1966, as well as 1991 and 1992. El Nino years are not always warmer and drier than average in the Pacific Northwest. A good example of this is 1972-73, which was colder, and 1982-83, which is wetter than average. This concludes part one of our briefing on ENSO. Please continue to visit National Weather Service webpages and the Climate Prediction Center for the latest weather and climate information. Look for parts two and three of this series to be released on our webpage and via social media very soon. Thank you for your time.